गुड मॉर्निंग
गुड मॉर्निंग सर
गुड मॉर्निंग सर
टुडे आई
गुड मॉर्निंग सर
गुड मॉर्निंग टुडे वी विल डिस्कस थ्री पोएम्स एट वन स्ट्रेच हेलो
यस सर
हेलो
यस सर
शिरीषा मैडम आर यू देयर हेलो
शैलजा
यस सर
शैलजा मैडम आर यू देयर Are you there? Are you there? Students say good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Please.
Good morning, sir.
I already told you I am not technically well versed. Please say whether you are. Am I audible to you? This question I will ask you for two or three times. Don't get frustrated. Don't get angry with me. Don't get angry with me. Don't get frustrated. Please.
Good morning, shall I start? I will teach you
three poems today. First poem is Enterprise by Nissim Ejikil. Write down. First poem is Enterprise by Nissim Ejikil. What poem?
Enterprise by Nissim Ejikil.
Second poem is Kamala Das introduction. Introduction by Kamala Das. An introduction by Kamala Das. Third poem, a love poem for a wife, by A.K. Ramanujan. A love poem for a wife by A.K. Ramanujan. These three poems we'll cover in these 2 hours. What are the three poems that we are going to discuss, friends?
Enterprise by Nissim Ejikil.
Love poem for a wife.
Introduction by Kamala Das.
Love poem for a wife by A.K. Ramanujan.
Fine, very good. Now I will talk about enterprise. First, you understand. A group of people will go on a pilgrimage. And as they go, when they go in a group, not all minds are same. Some people will say something. Some people will write about some fair. Village fair is taking place. So they write notes about village fair. When you go on a pilgrimage, one should have single-minded devotion. One should have concentration only on the goal, on the reaching the pilgrimage center and seeking the blessings of the God. That should be the idea of the pilgrimage. But here, enterprise means a new effort, a new endeavor. The meaning of enterprise by Nissim Ejikil is a new endeavor, a new effort. So this group of people are going on a pilgrimage. Number one, the first point is enterprise means an endeavor. Enterprise means a new effort, a novel effort, a new effort, an endeavor. This is enterprise. It is written by Nissim Ejikil. Nissim Ejikil is a very popular Indian English poet and also a playwright, right? He is no more. And Nissim Ejikil in this poem, short poem, talks about a group of people going on a pilgrimage. As they go, they get deviated. Some people get deviated by the village fair. Some people say, no, we have to go in some other direction. Those were the days that they did not go on flights. Those were the days that they did not go on trains. They went on foot. As they went on foot on a pilgrimage. Now the main agenda of this poem is, the moot point of this poem is, a group of people are going on a pilgrimage. First point is enterprise. Enterprise means endeavor. Endeavor means a new effort, a novel effort. So they are making a novel effort. These pilgrims are making a novel effort to go on a pilgrimage. As they go on a pilgrimage,
Which number, sir? Page number?
Listen to me, children. Hello? Madam, first listen to me. Don't disturb me. I will tell you everything in detail. Okay? Have patience. Okay. Page okay. number 72. Page number 72.
Okay.
First listen to me, madam, comfortably. First listen to me for 5 minutes. Only in 5 minutes you will understand the whole poem. Later you will realize it. So a group of what is the meaning of enterprise?
A new effort.
What is the endeavor here? What is the effort? New effort here?
A novel effort.
No, what is that novel effort here? What is the
group of people going to pilgrimage?
Very good. A group of people going on a pilgrimage is a novel effort. As they go, they get deviated. Some people say that no, we have to go in this direction. Some people say no, we will go in some other direction so that we will reach fast. Some people, so there are disagreements, write this word. There are disagreements in the group. And they are twice robbed also. They are twice robbed as they are going on a pilgrimage. They are twice robbed. So finally, this group becomes part. As there are disagreements, some people will leave this group and they go in some other direction. Some people, when they are going on pilgrimage, suppose we are going on a pilgrimage. Our concentration should be on God. But we should not eat batani, palli. Some people are interested only in eating. Some people are... Who is disturbing? Some people are interested on... It's a serious poem. Some people are interested only in eating foodstuffs. That should not be the case. So here, as the group of the people go on a pilgrimage, there are disagreements crop up. And as the disagreements crop up, there are divisions in the group. Shall I stop? Shall I leave the place?
Maheshwari, please mute.
What is this, Amma? What is this? Teaching in the PG class. ప్లీజ్ దయచేసి మీ అందరికి నమస్కారం పెట్టి చెప్తున్నా. డిస్టర్బ్ చేయొద్దు, దయచేసి మీ అందరికి నమస్కారం పెట్టి చెప్తున్నా. మీరంతా పెద్దవాళ్ళు.
సారీ సార్, అలా చెప్పకండి సార్. వి ఆర్ మేకింగ్
ఇంకా వినండి. సో యాజ్ ద గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్ గో, దేర్ ఆర్ డిసగ్రీమెంట్స్, దెన్ దేర్ ఆర్ డివిజన్స్, అండ్ ద గ్రూప్ బికమ్స్ స్మాలర్, అండ్ ఫైనల్లీ విత్ గ్రేట్ దే ఆర్ రాబ్డ్ ట్వైస్. Some people say that there is no water also. They don't even have basic amenities. Basic amenities are also not there. When they are going on a pilgrimage was not easy in those days. Nowadays, everybody can go to Kashi in 2 hours. If they get into flight, they can go to Kashi in 2 hours. Anywhere in the world, you can go by flight in 2-3 hours, in a short span of time, and enjoy and seek the blessings of God and come back comfortably with all comforts, with all the divine spirit. But those were the days. Going on a pilgrimage was not difficult. That is why this poem is titled as Enterprise. Enterprise means an effort. Going on a pilgrimage was not a Mickey Mouse task, was not going to an excursion, was not going to an exhibition. It is going on a arduous task. So as they move, as they go on pilgrimage, now there are disagreements, there are divisions, and they are robbed twice. Some people say there is no water, and some people say no, water is there. I am spelling C, so water is close by. Let us go in some other direction. So this group finally becomes divided. Some people go in some other direction, other people go in some other direction, and they don't even have basic amenities. They don't even have basic amenities like water. They're robbed twice. They are attacked and robbed twice. Finally, with great difficulty, they reach the pilgrimage. After reaching the pilgrimage, they understand home is where they gather the grace. Home is where they gather the grace. Home is where we have to gather grace. Home means God is within us. Home means soul. God, to search for God, we need not go outside on pilgrimage. Finally, after reaching the destination, they had realized the fact that after reaching the destination, with great difficulties, they reached the destination. After reaching the destination, they understand that God is within us. Home is where? Home means soul. Home is where we have to gather grace. Means we can see God within us. We need to see God. We need not take an external journey. To seek the blessings of God, if we take the internal journey, that's enough. To seek the blessings of the God, we have to seek. Home is where we have to gather the grace. The last line of the poem is very, very significant. Home means here soul. So after making a lot of efforts, they are going on a pilgrimage. When a group of people going on a pilgrimage, they are divided. There are disagreements. Some people are interested in village fair. How many sheep have been brought? How many have been sold? All these discussions, all these. So they don't have real interest. They don't have real interest. There are disagreements. There are divisions. They are robbed twice. There are no basic amenities. All these they do will not get it. Therefore, they get tired of it. And finally, Nisimejikil makes a statement, thesis statement. Home is where we have to gather grace. Home means soul. To search for God, we need not take an external journey. Home means soul. Home is where we have to gather grace. If you want to have the grace of God, if you have to have the blessings of God, you can see it within yourself. Traveling within one's own self. That's why it's a great spiritual poem. It is a spiritual poem. Enterprise. Enterprise means a new effort, a new direction, a novel effort, a new effort. So home is where we have to gather grace. Means we can see God within us. We need not make any external effort. Right? Anybody would like to summarize what I have told? Please summarize. Anybody summarize what I have told? Summarize. Then I will read the poem.
Yes, sir. Shall I, sir?
Please, madam, please. One thing. 1 minute. Enterprise it in and explain it in detail. Take your own time. Don't be in a hurry. There are no mistakes. It is not a mistake. Even if you add some of your ideas also, it is not a mistake. Students never commit mistakes. We are all one. A teacher is also a part of the students. Therefore, madam, please explain it in detail. All the points that I have explained right from beginning to the end, you explain. Then I will read the poem. Madam, please start.
Can I, sir? I am Annapurna.
Anybody? Any first? Somebody said no. Let us not disappoint her. Who said first?
Sir, it's me, sir. Yasmin. Sir, enterprise means it is a new endeavor or a new effort. And a group of people, that is the pilgrims, they are making a noble effort to go on a pilgrimage on foot. And as they march ahead, they get deviated on the path. And because a few of them say to move towards the other direction and some say to go on the other direction. So because of this, disagreement arises in the group. And later on, they were also robbed twice on their path as well. And so they go on some other direction. And so generally when we go to a pilgrimage, our concentration should be on God rather than speaking about the worldly affairs. And so as the disagreements crop up in this way, so the group also becomes smaller and they were very much wanted to quench their thirst, but they were unable to fulfill their basic provisions or the facilities like the food, water and all these things. But finally, with great difficulty, they reached the pilgrimage and they reached there and they realized the fact that God is within us and home is where they have to gather the grace.
Very good. Very good. Excellent. Excellent. Annapurna, madam, you also explain.
Okay, sir. Enterprise is the poem, sir. It is a spiritual poem written by Nisimejikil.
Hello? Okay.
I am telling, sir, you are not audible, sir.
Now audible. Now it is audible. Please tell.
Okay, sir. Enterprise is a spiritual poem written by Nisimejikil. Enterprise means a new effort or a noble effort. It is also meant for endeavor. A group of people went to a pilgrimage. In this poem tells about the pilgrimage. As they are going on foot to that place, there are so many conflicts arises between them. They divided into groups. Because of this, they got so many difficulties. After so many efforts, they reached that divine place, sir. After that, they agreed that home is where we have to gather grace. Grace means here soul, sir. Soul is the only one where we can see God. It means we cannot go outside to reach the God or to see the God. Okay, sir?
Very good, very good, very good. You also told wonderfully. Now, anybody, last chance, anybody would like to add anything? Or shall I start the poem? Shall I start the poem? Anybody would like to add? Anybody would like to add something? I'll start the poem, okay? Say okay.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Okay.
It start. Now listen to me carefully. The enterprise, actually, two or three lines I will explain first of all, and then I will start the poem. We hardly knew why we were there. We hardly knew why we were there. After reaching the destination, four lines I will explain, then I will come to first the whole of the poem I'll explain. Some important lines first I will explain, then I will explain the whole poem. Don't get confused. Which page number, don't get confused. You know, after reaching the destination, after reaching the destination, we hardly knew why we were there. They didn't know why they were there. Many a times it happens. In our life also, we want to reach a goal. After reaching the goal, we didn't know why we have struggled so hard to reach the goal. It happens. The trip had darkened every face. This trip, the pilgrimage has darkened every face. When you reach a pilgrimage, it should illumine your face. It should brighten your face. But on the contrary, the trip had darkened every face. So that the people, actually, when you go to a pilgrimage center to seek the blessings of God, your face should brighten up. Your face should lighten up, illumine. But on the contrary, it had darkened every face because of so many disagreements, so many conflicts, so many infightings. And finally, Nisimajikal comes to the conclusion that home is where we have to gather grace. It happens with all of us. After we go on a pilgrimage with great effort, and after reaching home, coming back home, then we sit and we eat happily. Then we come to the conclusion that why going to such long places? It is better we sit at home and meditate on God. Home is where we gather grace. Now I will start the poem. It started the page number 72. Page number 72. Lesson 10, Enterprise by Nisime Jikir. Listen to me carefully. It started as a pilgrimage, exalting minds and making all the burdens light. When you go on a pilgrimage, all the burdens become light. Your mind becomes intellectual. The second stage explored but did not test the call. The sun beat down to match our rage. It was very hot. We stood it very well, I thought. Observed and put copious notes on things the peasants sold and bought, the way the serpents and of goats, three cities where the sages had taught. But when the differences arose, look, when they are going on a pilgrimage, some people are interested in taking copious notes on the peasants sold and bought and serpents and goats. There is deviation. They are going on a pilgrimage. When they are going on a pilgrimage, their concentration should be purely on the pilgrimage. But here what happens? They are talking about the peasants sold and bought and the serpents and goats. Means there is deviation. They don't have that single-minded devotion. Three cities where a sage had taught, but when the differences arose, now the differences has arose on how to cross a desert patch. I told you, they were not going by flight. They were not going by train. They were going by on foot. And they, when they were going on foot, they have come across a deserted patch. And how to cross a deserted patch? Somebody said, let's go this way. Somebody said, let's go that way. We lost a friend whose stylish prose was quite the best of all our batch. There was a wonderful writer. He said, no, let us go this way. There was a writer in the group. He was an intellectual man. So that man said, no, let us grow in this way. He claims liberty. He claims liberty means he wants to go in some other direction. So they lost a friend. They lost a wonderful prose writer. They lost a writer because of the disagreements. Why disagreements? Because they came across a desert patch. Before desert patch, some people were interested in goats. Some people were interested in how many peasants have come, how many have sold it, how many peasants have come, how many serpents have been brought, how many goats have been sold. So they are interested only in that. They are interested only in that. Fair, village fair was taking place. So they were taking copious notes of the village fair. That should not happen, no? They should not happen. This here you can see how the deviation in their attitude. When you are listening to a class, your concentration should be only on the class, though it is an online class. If you concentrate in some other household works, what is the use? So concentration is important. They are going on a pilgrimage. Their sole objective is spiritual attainment. Their sole objective should be spiritual attainment. But instead of that, they are interested in village fairs. And when the desert patches come, the unity, they were unanimous. There was unity among them. But that unity has received cracks. And they started. And because there were cracks in the unity, we lost a friend whose stylish prose was quite the best of all our batch. There was a good writer. He said, no, let us go in some other direction because there was a desert patch. Going on a pilgrimage was not easy. A shadow falls on us and grows. Another phase was reached when we were twice attacked and lost our way. They were twice attacked. I told you, they were twice attacked and they lost their way. How difficult it is, look at it, pilgrimage. They lost their way. When problems crop up only, unity is tested. Unity is tested at family also, in a family also. Am I audible to you all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So when in family also, when problems crop up only, your unity is tested. So when the desert patch has come, a prose writer has deviated and he said, he left the way. They were twice attacked and lost our way. A section claimed its liberty. A section claimed its liberty means a section. After losing that friend means the friend leaving. Another group also has left. To leave the group, I tried to pray. Our leaders said, he smelt the sea. We noticed nothing as we went. They wanted water. Somebody said, no, I'm smelling sea. So there is no water also. I told you, even basic amenities were not available to them. Even basic amenities they were deprived of. Such was the arduous, difficult task going on a pilgrimage. And unity was there in the beginning. But later, there were cracks in the unity and there were divisions and disagreements. The divisions and disagreements makes the group into different sections. And finally, they reach the destination. A struggling crowd of little hope ignored what the thunder meant, deprived of common needs like soap. Some were broken, some merely bent. They were not even provided with basic facilities. Basic amenities like soap also was not there. When finally we reached the place, the place means what is the place?
Pilgrim.
Divine.
Very good. Pilgrimage. We hardly knew why we were there. After reaching the place, they hardly knew why we were there. I told you, no, it happens. Till the result, suppose tomorrow your results are about to announce. You get excited the whole night, you will not sleep. After getting the result, the whole of your mind will be blank. So with great difficulty, with great disagreements, with great divisions, finally they reach the destination. The destination means the place. The place means the pilgrimage center. After reaching the pilgrimage, they hardly knew why we were there. They hardly knew why we were there. The trip had darkened every face. The trip means, what is the trip here?
Pilgrimage trip, sir.
Pilgrimage. The pilgrimage had darkened every face. Why it had darkened every face? Because so many disagreements. When you go to a place, if you all go together happily, your face will illumine. Your face will brighten up. So with so many disagreements, with so many conflicts, internal conflicts, they reached the pilgrimage center. Our deeds were neither great nor rare. Their deeds were neither great nor rare. He says that going on a pilgrimage on foot is not great nor rare. Home is where we have to gather grace. Home is where we have to gather grace. The last line of the poem is very, very important. Home is where we have to gather grace. Home means, I already told you, instead of going on such a arduous journey, it is better we stay at home, and it is better we make an internal journey. It is better we take a spiritual journey inside. If we take a spiritual journey inside, it will be happy. Instead of going on an external journey, it is better we take an internal journey. What is the last line of the poem?
Home is where we have to gather grace.
Home means it is better we take the happiness inside. It is better we take about the God inside, we say. Yeah, next poem, Kamala Das, an introduction. Take out. Kamala Das, an introduction. Page number 82. Page number 82. Page number 82. Page number 82. Page number 83. Page number 83.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, if we want to explain the main theme of this, so what will be the theme, sir?
The main theme is taking spiritual journey. Spiritual journey. The main theme of the poem is spiritual journey. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Am I?
Sir, should we write a poem also in the exam?
Yeah, you have to write. You have to write. Page number 84. Page number 84. Page number 84. I don't know. Page number 84. Have you all opened it?
Yes, sir.
What is the next poem, yes, that we are? What is the earlier poem that we have read?
Enterprise.